see the architecture. Then you see the architecture here. Architecture, there are different parts. First part is you have the CPU. First part is CPU. Second part, you have input. Input device. Input device. Third part, we have output device. Output device. Fourth part, we have memory. That is random access memory. Random access memory. The fifth part is read-only memory. And these are executive processor. And this sixth part is application specific or specific circuit. Application specific circuit. Application specific. These are the three parts as far as embedded hardware is concerned. Here the processor is the center processing unit or processing device. It will vary the microcontroller to the processor. There are different types of microcontroller in the market. There are different microcontroller manufacturers. They are manufacturing the processor as well as microcontroller. Here the random access memory varies depending on microcontroller. There is in-chip or off-chip or on-chip. Memories are also available. Input device, depending upon your application, you can write the input device. Depending upon your application, you can write the output device. But these are the part of the parts which are present in microcontroller and different in the microcontroller. Without this, we cannot finish the sugar loaded system. Application specific circuitry is also there. This depends upon what type of application you are going to decide or you are going to build. Depending upon this application circuitry will be there. This is one type of block diagram. Another way is that, another representation. There are layer architectures also there. In layer architecture, that is called layer architecture. Layer architecture. Layer architecture. You have the hardware. This middle part is hardware, let's say one part. Second layer is second part. And third part is we are writing one two and three. This first part is your hardware. Where basically you can choose depending on which microcontroller you are going to use, what depending on which process you are going to do. Depending upon the application or nature of the complexity of your application. Second part is your OS. Second part is your operating system. There are different types of operating system you can choose depending on your application. Third part is your application software. Third part is your application software. As far as this layer structure or layer architecture is concerned, this is suitable for complex embedded system. For simple embedded system, these parts, three parts are also developed because of the, even if you don't this will use the complexity, this is the complexity. As far as depending upon type of application, you can choose, but in this case, even the circuit embedded application is small, in this case, hardware has to be there. If the application is small, then you may not be having the operating system or you may not be having the application software. In that small application, you have the hardware, and within this hardware, you can dump your program or hex files into the hardware. In that case, software power or firmware will be there. In this case, you have written some programming in C language, and you have dumped your hex file executed on the Part of the interrupt, you should do the interrupt to that account function, because wherever you are. either programmability or data value. Both are possible. We can program. We need to program data within the application program. And what else is here? I is what? These I and J are interfaces, output interfaces. Similarly, I is for serial port communication or serial port interfacing. Serial port interfacing. Serial port interfacing. And J is your parallel port interfacing. Basically, these are interfacing. Parallel port interfacing. So, this is the architecture. This is any embedded system. These are the parts of embedded system. As far as hardware is concerned, you should have this power supply, reset circuitry, and oscillating circuitry. You should have input device interfacing and device driver. You should have application specific circuitry, depending upon application, you should connect to the component hardware program support. And C part is the output device interfacing and output device driver. And this part, this is the processor which you are going to select or microcontroller. And this part is your this part is the particular interconnector. This G part is your G part is your